happy anniversary. It's my honor to bring you on here. You're a good fella.
As we say around here, the feeling is mutual.
All right. Pour it to him, son.
Thank you so much. 50 years ago, I made my first appearance on the Grand Ole Opry. And I was singing a song about a teenager who couldn't afford to give his sweetheart a box of chocolates or a bouquet of flowers or nothing. Just one rose and a little candy bar called Baby Ruth. I know a lot of y'all probably weren't even born when this record came out, but it's what brought me to the Grand Ole Opry. And the young man who wrote that song went on to become one of country music's greatest songwriters. He had a hand in so many hits, wrote so many hits for so many people. And I'm so proud and honored that he's visiting here with us tonight. Before we sing his song, I want you to meet and greet John D. Loudermilk. Welcome to the song.
A full-fledged member of the Grand Ole Opry, Mr. George Hamilton IV. Yeah. 50 years flies by, doesn't it, George?
This is my musical home place, Pete, as you know, and this is home to me. I'm so proud and honored to be a small part of the world's greatest country music.
Well, George, we, all of us at the Opry are grateful for all the contributions you've made over these 50 years. You've not only made some magical moments here in the Grand Ole Opry stage, but you've taken the great message of country music and the Grand Ole Opry to the world as the International Ambassador of Country Music, and for that we're grateful as well. And as a token of this special evening, one of the things we'd like to present you with is this print, George Hamilton IV celebrating 50 years as a member of the Grand Ole Opry, the International Ambassador of Country Music, February 6, 2010. And since we are we are marking the passage of time. We thought there would be nothing better than to present you with this Hamilton Railway Grade pocket watch, which was made in the 1960s, the decade you became a member. And on the back is a hand engraving, George Hamilton IV, Grand Ole Opry, 1960 to 2010. So use this to mark this special moment in time. And, thank you very much, George. And we would love to have another song for you. Can you do that for us? Great. Thank you. I'll hang on to that. Thanks.
Come on, Pete. Let's get out of the way.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Mr. Fisher. And Mike Snyder. Please make welcome George Hamilton V, believe it or not. He's coming out here after that. A few years after Rose and the Baby Ruth, John D. Loudermilk called me up on the phone and said, I got a new song for you. And I figured since we got lucky with the Rose and the Baby Ruth, I ought to hear it. And so I said, John, what is it this time? A Petunia and the Mars Bar? And he says, no, man, you two ought to be singing about high school romances and teenage quarrels. This is something new in country music. I said, what, for instance? He said, well, it's kind of an example of nitty-gritty, uptight, folk country, psychedelic, hillbilly love ballads. He was right. He was right.